Hello, Pythoneer. Want to transform your data efficiently with Python's built-in map function? Here's all you need to know. The map function lets you apply a function to every item in a list or any other iterable. No for loops needed. Let's start with a basic example. We'll square each number in a list. All we're doing is applying a lambda function, x squared 2, to each item in numbers inside the map function. The result? 14916, our original list, squared. With map, it's that quick. Now, you might be wondering, why not just use a list comprehension? Good question. Here are some advantages of map over list comprehensions. Readability. Map clearly shows the function being applied. Performance. Slightly faster for built-in functions. Memory efficiency. Returns an iterator, saving memory on large datasets. So while both are great tools, map is a strong choice for straightforward function applications, especially with larger data or when working with multiple iterables. Now, let's take it up a notch and use map with a regular function and multiple lists. Suppose we're summing pairs of numbers from two lists. Then we call the maps function to add the elements from list A and list B one by one into the new list summed. This gives us 5, 7, and 9 as output. Notice how easy it is to work with multiple lists. Map handles it for us. Now let's push it further with nested data. Say we have a list of dictionaries, each representing a user, and we want to capitalize each user's name. This example shows that map can even work on complex structures. By passing each dictionary to capitalize name, we transform the name key for every user in the list, giving us the names Alice, Bob, and Carol capitalized. With map, you're in control of massive data transformations with just a few lines. Now, you're ready to use map in your next project. Remember, when you need concise, scalable transformations, map has your back. Thanks for watching. On the left is the next video you won't want to miss. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and happy coding.